Hi, welcome to Guy's Art Studio. Today we have a drawing, a bit of a doodle, that we will then turn into a watercolour painting. So once I've decided what I want to draw, in this case it was an iris flower, I did a doodle, a pencil drawing, traced it with a bit of tracing paper, flipped it over and drew on the back of it, and transferred the drawing onto a piece of watercolour paper. That allows you to move it around and alter your composition. So here I am tracing one of my doodles, just changing it slightly to a pattern or shape that I like. What you have to do with the tracing paper to get it the right way around is flip the tracing paper over, draw on the back of it, then you can flip it over again and draw over it on top of the watercolour. So here I have the watercolour paper and I'm just drawing over some of the lines that I've transferred onto it. I wanted the flower to be a blue stroke purple flower. And for a contrast for the back, if you look at a colour wheel, opposite the purples and blues are yellows and oranges. So at this stage, all I knew I wanted to do is draw and paint some flowers, blue flowers, with a yellow, orangey background. I wanted to put some greys in there as well. As we can see here, I'm using masking fluid to mask out any of the paperwork that I don't want to be stained by the paint. Masking fluid can be added at any stage through the painting. So if you add it at the beginning to preserve some whites, and then at other stages through the painting, you can rub it out and add it over the top of colour. I'm now adding water onto the watercolour paper. Don't have to worry too much where the masking fluid is, but trying to keep it careful and detailed in and around the shape of the flower. Using a large brush to get the paper as wet as I can, as quickly as I can. And now dropping in some yellow in the background, wet on wet. Adding some different colours now to the background. It's still wet, and adding wet paint to the wet, so moves out it through the water, dabbing it with a cloth if it's a little too wet. Peeking out the background. So I've dried it off. I'm just going to add in some grey now because I want the background to be greys and yellows. So just need to choose basically where I want some greys. So here now I've dried off the painting and I've added some water onto the flowers, onto the petals, and now I'm dropping in some blue and some violets. There will be a list of different colours that I've used at the end of the film. So it's dry now. I'm just going in with a brush and blending a few little bits here and there. Messing about with it really. At this stage I've rubbed off some of the masking fluid, not all of it, but bits here and there, so I can now paint in the bits and pieces that were actually masked before. I've added a little bit more masking fluid now over the top of the flowers. And now that's allowing me to drop in some more oranges and different colours over the background. I've got some more interesting shapes masked out. So I've rubbed a bit more of the masking fluid off, and here I am now painting a bit more of the background in, creating a bit of an illusion of clouds. For this painting I've used cadmium red, cadmium yellow, lemon yellow, cobalt blue, ultramarine blue, phthalo blue, and a very small amount of Payne's grey. I have also used purple. Thank you for watching Guy's Art Studio. Please hit the like and the subscribe button if you wish to see more of my art.